We are back in the matchup Splay Buzzer against Peter Host in the Farmers League group stage, or the late group stage, as they are catching up their missed match. And we are already in the fourth game here, and the score is 2-1 for Splay Buzzer. So Peter Host managed to get a decisive victory in one of the games. So very nicely played. And yeah, now we are on Land Nomad here. And yeah, I'm excited to see if Peter Host manages to get a draw from Splay Buzzer in this match. Or if Splay Buzzer will find his strength again and defeat Peter Host. So we have here Vikings versus the Mongols. I think Mongols should be very nice on Land Nomad, because there's a lot of hunt on Land Nomad, and their hunters work a lot faster. While Vikings, I'm not sure if Vikings have any relevant bonus for Land Nomad. Standard Land Nomad map. So we have a lot of, especially food, on the outside of the map. So lots and lots of food. Also most of the, there is gold and stone in the middle, but also a lot on the edges of the map. So the TCs are quite far away from each other. So yeah, we'll see how long it takes them to actually find each other. So let's check the scouting. So yeah, Splay Buzzer already scouted a lot here. Though interestingly, his villagers spawned quite close to each other. While Peter Host didn't scout as much, I think, but he started way over there, so he has this strip scouted. Splay Buzzer already going for loom. Bringing in a boar, collecting some raw sheep. Peter Host here also bringing in the boar, which is very nice. He does not have loom yet, but he's already more than, he's one villager ahead already. And we see this Splay Buzzer's idle TC time is rising because he doesn't have enough food. Probably he has to force drop off. Those villagers have all the food he needs, he just has to drop it off. And all this idle time, sets him back, I think, even more than, more than one villager, because he already has loom. So he's two villagers behind already. So this is, should be quite an opportunity for Peter Host to use this head start here. Peter Host already sending out a villager for scouting. Probably will build some houses around the map. Did you see the boar? He sees the boar. Brings in the next one. So very nice. Also taking the hunt here, which is quite strong with the Mongols, as said. Dropping houses over the map. As if Splay Buzzer is also doing this. So yeah, let's see how long it takes for those players to find each other. Meanwhile, Splay Buzzer gathered a lot of sheep. Wow, there's 10 sheep already, bringing in the next boar. Peter Host does not have that many sheep, but he finds another boar here, which he will surely bring in soon. This, I guess, a scouting villager. He knows about the sheep here. So maybe he's going to collect that. Yeah, resource-wise, also very nice. Be the host. Yeah, clearly ahead of Splaybuzzer. Now almost three villages ahead, because Splaybuzzer had so much idle time, but Peterhost is also now increasing his idle town center time. Yeah, but he has a lot more resources collected by now, so 300 more resources collected at this point is huge. And now he already even has the resources for Feudal Age, though typically on Nomad starts, yeah, it takes a bit longer for the players to click up. And so 18 would be quite fast, but the Feudal Aggression Scouts are usually not that strong on these Nomad starts because the woodline is just so protected. So I was also going for some hunt, bringing in yet another boar. And yeah, also moving to some. I think that was a misclick, but sheep got slaughtered. Let's check the scouting. So Peterhost has not found Splaybuzzer, but could find him now. I guess this sheep will. Yeah, he will lose the sheep, and now he knows where Splaybuzzer is, or at least the. At least the neighborhood. While Splaybuzzer still, I think, has no clue where Peter could be. Yeah, scouting on the top here. Yeah, but he's still far away from finding Peterhost's town center. Both players are up now. Peterhost half a minute ahead. And he just let the sheep rot. Didn't even take it. Now moved all the villas to wood here, and is again going for the barracks. So let's see if we again see a couple of militias or men-at-arms. Then even now going for another mill here to collect the hunt. I'm not sure if this is. I mean, yeah, sure he can collect it, but he still has so many sheep here that he could take instead. I'm not sure, maybe he wants to save it for later. Yeah, still roaming around here, hasn't scouted Peterhost yet. I mean, he has scouted this house, so he could expect him to be around there. Yeah, Peterhost. Yeah, he's going for a fast castle. He almost has resources. Yeah, he's lacking a bit of food, but if he sells stone, though he built two outposts, so he doesn't have the 200 stone to sell. He doesn't even need it because the hunters gathered the rest of the food, and he's up. So very, very nicely done by Peterhost here. He's even two villages ahead of Splaybuzzer. Still two builds ahead, so yeah, let's see what. Yeah, Splaybuzzer now switching on to sheep here, but it will look dire for him when Peterhost reaches the castle age. Splaybuzzer now going for scouts, and I don't like this because scouts almost always. They're almost always a trap on these Nomad maps. Because, yeah, the woodline is completely secure. I mean, sure, he could do some damage on this gold because it's completely open. But, yeah. I mean, two scouts for. They can even be fought off by the villagers. So, I don't like that too much. Should have rather invested the. Or save the resources for Castle Age. Even if they're just for scouting, then just build one if you still haven't found your enemy. But he should. No, he still has no clue. Now, only now he finds his enemy. And yeah, he's roaming around, but he doesn't find any damage. I mean, he could maybe fight here, but Yeah, Beedos will just relocate them. No damage to be found. Now you should probably... This should probably be walled off, but yeah, he already has a spearman even there. And that spearman is probably enough to fight off the scouts. Yeah, Spray Buzzer now also going for market. Yeah, but what is Peterhouse doing with his Castle Age timing? And he's going for Cav Archers. So that is indeed very nice. Since... yeah, the Mongols Cav Archers, they fire faster. So that's a very strong play here by Peterhouse. And once he has a couple of them, he can go forward. Yeah, the scouts are inconsequential to the Cav Archers. And yeah, they probably die to this spearman. So not too interesting here, but let's look what... Yeah, it's fall off. Let's look what Peterhouse is doing forward. Yeah, look at this. They will soon be dead. Now even a second spearman. And now Peterhouse has to find damage. There's an idle villager here, which he could pick off if he found him. Yeah, but he could also pick off villagers here. Now he should probably wait for a couple more Cav Archers then, so that he can... also kill the villagers, because now he will only this will only cost Playbuzzer to relocate them. Yeah, as Playbuzzer also dropping an archer at two archery ranges, probably going for skirmishers. I'm not sure. I'm not sure what do Vikings. Yeah, okay, they do have the skirms. Oh, they don't have elite skirms. Or do they have? I'm not sure how to... No, I don't think they get elite skirms, and they also don't get crossbow upgrades, so... Yeah, I'm not sure if he has to go double archery range here for that. Just to defend two... Ah no, it's not the two, just two anymore. Where's the rest of Peterhouse's army? There's 11... Ah, there they are. Yeah, just move them in. Yeah, but they... I don't think the skirms do too much here. Because you can't upgrade them really. I mean, he's fletching, but... Peterhouse now going for Botkin Arrow even. And with enough... Yeah, I mean, he has the mobility and the Castle Age unit against Feudal Age skirmishers, so... I don't like it too much. Should maybe go for some siege instead. Now that he's Castle Age. Yeah, Peterhouse here going for a nice second TC. Moving onto stone. Yeah. We have the two scouts, they lived, but they are now living in exile. And now, yeah, the Cav Archers are in, and yeah, the skirms don't do too much, because the Cav Archers can just run. And the skirms are just too slow. So yeah, Spellbuzz is boxed in here by a couple of Cav Archers, and here the skirms just die. Yeah, his players are desperately upgrading his skirmishers. But doesn't even get the elite upgrade, so... it's pretty disastrous. Yeah, I think you probably should go for some scorpions or something instead. Or maybe even knights that he doesn't have. Yeah, he just doesn't have the resources. Also, it's 12 villagers behind, so now going for a second CC, but it looks really, really good for Peter Host, who is pressuring Splay Buzzer here. And yeah, moving in more and more cav archers, breaking through this palisade wall here. Now finally Splay Buzzer going for a siege workshop, which Peter Host also should do. I mean, he probably should just build a siege workshop here or here. And then he could deny this wood line, or most of this wood line, with just a mangonel here, pressure the TC. But yeah, 10 villagers ahead still. And yeah, now he's moving forward, so this, that's the GG castle is coming. Yeah, and that's a GG castle. Let's get out of this game, Splay Buzzer. You are rusty as fuck. And yeah, it's pretty nice. A pretty nice performance by Peter Host here. Looks like he's going to take a second win even from Splay Buzzer here. So yeah, really, really nice. Going into this match as, yeah, basically as the underdog against the former King Splay Buzzer, but yeah, clearly showing why Splay Buzzer is not the king anymore. I mean, Peter Host is also a king since he won last year's Couch Cup. While Splay Buzzer's glorious times are way further back time. Now also mixing in step lances, which yeah are very nice for picking off the skirmishers of Splay Buzzer. Splay Buzzer now going for a third TC here because he has to leave his starting TC. And I'm not sure what Peter Host is doing with all his cav archers now. He should move in here. I mean, Splay Buzzer has nothing, is one mangonel, is a couple of feudal age skirms. Oh, I was wrong, he does get elite skirmishes. So that's okay. I'm just unable to correctly read this tech tree here. Okay, what's the little blue spots underneath? Ah, it's what he already researched. Ah, okay, so that's my bad. He does get elite skirmisher, but probably should have gotten that upgrade a while ago. Yeah, now seems to hold it quite okay. But yeah, but he's always on the defense, squeezed in by Peter Host. And yeah, I think we're just waiting for the final push. Okay, let's see this engagement. Okay, that's pretty bad for Peter Host. Should move in, yes, with a step lancer. Oh, but even that takes quite some damage because it doesn't have the, only has one defensive upgrade. Maybe you should just go for a couple of knights here instead of the, I mean the step lances are cute, but maybe just a couple of knights, they have a lot more armor, and then the skirmishers will do nothing against them. now, yes, he roamed around here. He should, instead of attacking the house, he should probably just have gone for the villages. His players are now going for another TC here. And yeah, Peterhost lacks the punch here, only now going for siege finally. Going for another stable. But yeah, unable to close out the game here. And this even gives Playbazer time to boom back into this game. So only 6 villages behind now. Even though Peterhost killed a lot. Peterhost also going for another TC here. Yeah, but not able to do the... to deal out the decisive blow. I mean, you have the mobility, yes, just roam in here. Yes, move the army down here. And Flavors are now dropping a defensive castle here, which is really, really necessary, but oh, it could, this could be dangerous. The step lances here. Oh, this will be... they can kill so many villagers. Yeah, they don't manage to deny the castle, but still pick off a couple of villages. Now here, picking off the mangonel. But yes, Plevas is still... he's unable to get out of the defensive. The steplancers will pick off his skirmishes. And though the castle stabilizes him, I think it only... yeah, it delays the inevitable if he doesn't manage to get something out of out on the field. Now he's going for berserks, and yeah, I'm not sure, because while they are not too slow, they just lack the mobility of the cavalry. Yeah, he has to get out of the defensive here, but... they are quite successful in picking off the mangonels here, because Peterhost left them almost undefended. Steplancers too far away to defend them properly. And yeah, but the will count's almost even by now. Another unprotected mangonel here. Now I should be able to pick the berserks off. Though I'm not sure if the berserks are actually weaker than the steplancers. Maybe with range, the steplancers have an advantage here. Now Peterhost again booming ahead. Also roaming around here. I mean, he has a huge army advantage now, but he just can't, bring it on the field. Though he's probably able to deny this castle though. He shouldn't run away. Another berserker here. And yeah, we see the range of the steplancers is just incredibly strong. We should move the... what is this? Cav archers. You should move them in. I mean, he might have been able to deny the castle here, but moves out. And yes, he is. Yeah, he's saying build your castle, I'll trap it down because I'm on my way to imp.
Yes.
As he clicked up. Yes. And only now going for horse collar. Yeah, it's Blavers, he has so much resources, he should also buy his way up to imp. or at least build up some army, because yeah, even if he reached Imp, Spellberser just doesn't have any army. He has three berserks here, but they do nothing against anything what Peter Host has. So what Peter Host probably could, or what could be useful for Peter Host is a second castle, so that he can build the traps from two castles there. Yes, Playbus now buying himself up to Imperial Age, but Peter Host is 2 minutes ahead already. And once he has traps, he will trap this down, then he can roam in. And yeah, Spellbus has nothing to defend. I mean, he's building a couple of berserks. But I'm not sure if that's the unit he needs here. Both players going for some upgrades. Defensive upgrade for the berserks, husbandry for the cav of Peter Host. But yeah, now the first trap is being produced. And yeah, I mean, Peter Host just has to wait. I mean, just pump out the traps, trap down the castle, and then raid Spellbuzzer to death. So yeah, not too exciting here. More of a waiting game by now. You should just make sure that he protects his trap. Yes, and he's moving in. Yeah, I know. It's just a waiting game. Until Peter Host squeezes Spellbuzzer out of this game. Spellbuzzer also reached him, but yeah, he has nothing. He's building a skirms now. Also building a trap. Okay, in this castle at least. But what will he do with his trap? I mean, he can sit here and try to snipe the traps, but yeah. Having 12 berserks. Oh, this is pretty nice. Pretty nice mangana shots here. Yeah, Peter Host does not have villagers to repair here. Now the berserks engage, and let's see how this goes. Yeah, but he just has too few. Yeah, it's just too few berserks, and yeah, I expect the GG being called soon, because yeah, Spellbuzzer has nothing, and there's the GG. And yeah, GG, well played from Spellbuzzer says GG, well played, and well played indeed. So taking two victories from the former king here, Peter Host, yeah, managing to get a draw out of this matchup. And yeah, we can see here Peter Host has had an advantage over most of the game here, just having huge army numbers. As he just a huge military. And also more resources over most of the game, because it, yeah, just more villages, because Spellbuzzer, yeah, from the beginning even, because Spellbuzzer went for Loom much earlier, and even idled his TC. And yeah, very nicely played. Also very nice that the players are catching up their missed matches. And yeah, all in all, and a very nice series. And yeah, see you in the next series. Bye.